start this video, can we talk about how good Gabrielle Sidibe look? Look at her. A freaking amazing. You better work, girl. Yes, my sleeve sister. Listen, if that ain't motivation and inspiration right there, y'all. Anyway, welcome to Mama June's From Not to Hot. Oh my God, y'all, we're on episode 5 already. Mama Frankenstein. I can't wait to see what is going to happen. Thank you all for watching all my previous videos and sharing them, liking them, commenting. We have a good time, especially I got an army already set up to get Jennifer. We're going to get you, girl, when we see you, okay? We're going to get you on behalf of Mama June. But anyway, I'm kidding, for real. But anyway, so let's see what's going on in this episode. So we start off with pretty much a recap of what happened the episode before. Yeah, we know how that ended. So, you know, June pretty much is feeling down. Like, I can't believe my surgery has been canceled. And I can't believe I let Jennifer and Sugar Bear get to me the way that they did. Then it pans over to Jennifer calling and talking to Janice. And Janice happens to be the sister-in-law of June. Sugar Bear introduced Jennifer and Janice, and they've been friends now for about a year. So she calls her to vent about the events that have been happening and leading up to present day. So she pretty much makes it seem like all this is June's fault, of course. You know, she's like, yeah, she got mad because I bought Alana a cupcake. Like, how you gonna get mad because I bought her a simple cupcake? And nobody had a conclusion on the last video that Jennifer is a hater, okay? And then she is even, like, blaming, like, Sugar Bear for not pretty much, like, taking up for her. And did we even know that Sugar Bear had a real name? Like, who knew Sugar Bear's name was Mike? Like, I had no idea. But I guess now we know his name is Mike, right? And pretty much Janice lets her know, look, when you marry Sugar Bear, you're going to have to marry him for good or for bad. And if that bad is June because of Alana, you're going to have to take it, girl, because this is what you choose. And now this is the life and the family that you want to be a part of. Well, after that, we see the kids, Pumpkin and Alana, playing on with June's treadmill, and Big Mike is supposed to be there babysitting them. So they have goldfish lined up on the treadmill. Alana's at the other end of the treadmill, and as the treadmill is going, the goldfish are going into Alana's mouth. Now, my first thing was like, oh, gross. I hope that they wipe the treadmill down because people's feet have been on there in sneakers and, we're not gonna worry about that. So in walks June, and she has an attitude. She's upset because her surgery has been canceled. So she's fussing with them about, you know, how the treadmill is not a toy and she doesn't want them playing with it or whatever. And, you know, she fusses with Big Mike saying, like, hey, you're supposed to be babysitting them and I can't even leave you here with them and without, you know, all this commotion going on in the house. So June is just pretty upset, and the kids notice that, and she goes upstairs to take a nap. Well, they wake her up and they make her a snack. She claims she's not hungry, but eventually they get her out the bed and they are taking her somewhere to kind of boost up her spirits. So once they arrive to the location, we find out that it is at the playground where Kenya and her work out at, and Kenya is sitting there waiting for her. So June is like, all right, what's going on here? So Pumpkin lets her know that Jennifer made an appointment with the surgeon for 2 weeks out because he has an opening. So they let her know that if you can lose these 15 pounds in the next 2 weeks and meet your goal weight, then you can have your skin removal surgery. And Alana and Pumpkin are there and let her know that we're here to support you as well. We're going to work out with you. We're going to eat right with you. We're going to be your support system that you need so that way you don't fail and you can make this skin removal surgery a reality. So, you know, Kenya, you know, he loves motivation. He loves working out and stuff. So he is so excited that the kids are going to work out too, because that's all he wanted too. Was for the kids to come and be a part of the working out and everything and eating right as well. So now that the kids are on board, Kenya is excited. So what they do, they ride bikes. June doesn't know how to ride a bike. So he actually got her a bike with training wheels on it. And even though she still was a little like wobbly and stuff, you know, Kenya, like I said, is always supportive and motivating. And he was right there by her side, helping her, making sure that she didn't fall off of this bike. Well, after the bike ride, they get back home and they're making salads. And the girls are like, yeah, this lettuce and cucumbers and tomatoes, yeah, this ain't for us. So they go sit down in the family room, and Alana stumbles upon June's candy stash. She's going to be in a whole heap of trouble. Well, the girls decide to throw June under the bus and tell Kenya what they found. And he starts digging and asking June, like, whose is this? And, you know, she starts saying, oh, it's the girls. And the girls are like, no, it ain't ours. So he starts finding other food that's been stashed away. And he's very pissed. And so were the girls. They're like, look, we're breaking what we are normally used to doing. And we're doing this for you so that you can have surgery. And now you are not doing what you're supposed to do. You're sitting here snacking and hiding food and stuff. So Kenya was very pissed, and he decides to leave. And June thought he was playing, but he was oh so serious. So while she's sitting there, you know, she's still upset, and Jennifer calls her. She sends her a voicemail because she already knows that Jennifer is her sore spot, and Jennifer is the reason why she's been binge eating and going back to unhealthy eating habits. So she sends her a voicemail. And you know Jennifer and her smart ass mouth, she lets June know, you know, what was said the other night was uncalled for. I'm pretty sure that you didn't mean to say that. So I think we should have a talk to talk about how you pretty much talk to me and Sugar Bear this way. I'm looking like, does she not understand like what she said? I guess not. But, you know, she pretty much wants to see Alana, and, you know, she wants June to give her a call back, but June doesn't do it. So June ends up walking down the street, and you know, we're just thinking she's just walking the neighborhood, but she actually walks into a support group for weight loss individuals. And it was a small group, but sometimes a small intimate group is even better than a larger group, because you can you can build trust and friendships and get accountability partners, which is very, very important when we're doing this weight loss journey. So June explains what happened and, you know, where she's been stashing food at. And everybody kind of chimes in with her and says, yeah, I stash food here. I stash their food there. Just to let June that you are not in this on your own. You're not alone. We all have done what you're doing, and we're here to help. So, you know, they all make a vow that they're going to sit and help one another with this weight loss. So we see June working out with her family. She's working out with Kenya. She's working out with Big Mike. Big Mike is driving the minivan behind her while she's running down, jogging down the street. You got her and Alana doing sit-ups. So it was really good to see that everybody is chipping in and helping June. Now, Gina calls because now it's 2 weeks and her surgery is coming soon. So Gina calls right before the car comes to pick June up for the airport. So she says, June, how much do you weigh? So June is like, I weigh 190. So Gina was like, all right, you get here, you already know what it's gonna be about. You're not gonna get surgery. So she was like, yeah, I know, I'm there. Don't worry about it. Let me finish getting these bills together before my car comes. So the car comes, and the girls are saying goodbye. You know, they're crying, especially June, because she's upset that, you know, the girls are not going to be there. She felt like she can get through the surgery a little bit better with the girls there. But the girls are going to stay behind, and June heads on to LA. So as soon as she gets to LA, they go to the surgeon's office for pre-op care. And we all know that pre-op care is pretty much the care and the tests and stuff that you have to do prior to any surgery. So they weigh June, and the nurse doesn't tell June how much she weighs. She just has like a concerned look on her face. So she says she's going to go out and tell the doctor, and the doctor will be in shortly. So, you know, Gina's sitting there looking like, okay, well, how much do you weigh? And June was like, I don't know. We all forgot that June is like legally blind and she can't see that far away. So she was just like, oh my God. So the doctor comes in, and he lets June know that there are some tests that they have to take. You know, her labs did come back perfectly fine. She has to get a mammogram, which is just regular protocol or whatever, because she's getting, you know, a breast job. And he lets her know that, you know, your weight was 193. So Gina and June are a little upset, and June is thinking like, oh my God, I did all that work and I'm still only 3 pounds shy. But the good news is that the doctor lets her know that since you're only, you know, 3 pounds down or up from where I want you to be, and you've come from where you were, I'm still going to go ahead and approve you for surgery. So June and Gina were happy. The next morning, you know, June comes into the office and he marks her body up on where he's going to liposuction and where he's going to cut and where he's going to put the implants and, you know, all his little roadmaps to how he's going to sculpture her body. And, you know, the anesthesiologist comes in, gives her that nice cocktail of goodness to make her warm and fuzzy and puts her to sleep. June wakes up with a new body per se. She has breasts, and then we actually got to see some of the breasts work getting done. Also, she got a tummy tuck, so they show, you know, the removal of the skin just a tad bit online, just a tad bit on the show, and also some of the liposuction that they did. June wakes up in so much pain. She was like, oh my God, I did not know I was going to be in this much pain. Like, it feels like somebody is ripping my insides out. And so while she's sitting in recovery, in walks the girls. And so she wakes up, you know, they wake June up and she's like, well, what are y'all doing here? Like, she had no emotions. She wasn't excited, nothing. I'm pretty sure she wasn't excited, but her outside did not show it. So they were like, oh my God, your breath stink. And, you know, they were just... Our kids just have no filter at all. So even Alana just starts like crying, like, and Pumpkin's like, you crying? Like, what are you crying for? She's like, I'm gonna miss mama's floopa. Remember, it's a fupa, not a floopa. But you know, they're like looking underneath the covers and checking around and letting her know, hey, you slim and trim now, mama. So, you know, she's very, very excited. The doctor comes in and lets, you know, the girls know that we can't baby her. She has to get up and walk so that she doesn't get any blood clots. You're not bedridden, so don't feel that way. And you have to make sure that you don't gain no weight after this surgery, pretty much. Like, you have to maintain this because it will all be done in vain. And we cannot have that. Well, Gina gets the girls and Mama June a recovery house with a medical assistant there that's going to help June during these next 3 weeks of recovery. The medical assistant, you know, helps June up and helps her go to the bathroom, brush her teeth, and she's just showing the girl, well, Pumpkin, exactly what has to be done in order to help June out. Well, you know, they wake Alana up, time to get up is, you know, June is in so much pain again still, and you know, she is having a little bit of, I'm going to say, buyer's remorse. Alana wakes up and, you know, she's talking to June and, you know, she's just like, mom, your boobs, you know, your stomach. Like, Alana starts to get sad as well because now her mom is starting to change in front of her. You know, since she's been born, her mom has been heavy, has all this extra skin, you know, and now her mom is totally changing. Alana, it's a lot for Alana as well. And I don't think June took in consideration how not only it was going to change her, but how it was going to change everybody around her as well. While they're sitting there, Jennifer calls again. Of course, June sends her the voicemail. And of course, Jennifer then lets her know on the voicemail, I'm not going to leave you alone until you contact me and let me know what Alana's schedule was like so we can meet up for this wedding and blah, 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 blah. Jennifer, girl. If you have to, find another flower girl is my suggestion to you, okay? But, you know, Jennifer in her little nasty email, I mean, her little nasty voicemails, ugh. But anyway, the girls are eating, and so the medical assistant is showing them how to empty out her drains. And yes, it is a gross process. Alana pretty much got up, pooed all over her mouth, and was like, yeah, I'm not hungry no more. I'm gonna go, yeah, mind my business somewhere else. So she's showing Pumpkin what to do. And she actually even accidentally squirts June in the face with some of the air. And you know, it's like fluid from your insides there. And it's kind of like a little bit floats back up in June's floats back up in June's face or whatever. But you know, the girls have to know how to do this for when the medical assistant leaves and not gonna be able to, you know, do all this for them and help June. Well, 4 days later, they go back to the doctor's office to get the bandages removed from her incisions. And yeah, that tape hurts. And June is like, eek! you know, I can't do this, you know. So they finally get the tape off and he's looking at her and he's like, you know, you're gonna be able to see your vag now when you sit down. You're gonna be able to see your pelvic bones and everything. Like, your body looks amazing. And June is starting to like look at her body and she again is starting to have buyer's remorse. Like, I look like Frankenstein. Like, my body is all chopped up, you know, hunched over. I don't feel good. The pain is not as what I expected. Like, I don't even know if I'm gonna go through with the next set of surgeries because I didn't anticipate all this to occur. And, you know, she's having regrets. And yeah, it's really sad. And this is why I said in the beginning, make sure that you do these surgeries. This is why in the beginning I suggested that you have to do these surgeries for yourself and not for nobody else, because you're the one that's going to be going through all this pain. You're the one that's going to be, you know, going through all these bad feelings and emotions, and you're kind of now looking at it as like, why did I even get this done? Like, should I have even gotten it done? Like, I'm in that much pain. So, you know, the doctor pretty much lets her know. I'm sorry, I'm just itchy. The doctor pretty much lets June know that you're looking great and you're looking fabulous. You know, time will heal. Just make sure you continue to walk. Walking is what's going to particularly help you out. So the girls have to go back to Georgia to go back to school. And, you know, they're eating candy and junk and whatever right in front of June. And June is trying to explain to them, like, I don't want you all to have to go through all this surgery as I'm going through. You see my pain. You see what I've gone through even when I was heavy. And my medical conditions, and now having to get all these surgeries, I don't want this to happen to you all. So yes, you all helped me out to get this surgery, and that's what you think that that's all it was here for, but I really want you all to adapt it as an actual like lifestyle. The girls are not trying to hear that. They're just sitting there eating their food. They're like, whatever, mama, like, we're just gonna eat our food. It ain't bothering us now. You know, you got your surgeries, you should be good and happy. But she really isn't. And she's trying to make them aware of, you know, the awareness of being obese. And, you know, she told Pumpkin, like, you are not even going to be able to handle, like, the surgeries that I'm going through because you're a freaking crybaby. But they don't want to hear it. Well, 2 weeks after surgery, and June meets up with Gina. So she walks in. She has, like, a little walker, like if you're elderly, like one of those kind of walkers. And she's walking into the restaurant. And, you know, Gina's asking her, how is she doing? How is she feeling? And June, of course, is just saying, look, I don't feel good. Like, I don't know why I did this surgery. And, you know, I'm in a lot of pain. I didn't anticipate all this pain. So Gina's like, well, you know, it's almost time for you to get ready for the next set of surgeries. Then this will be your last surgery, you know, to get your neck and to get your bat wings done. And June is like, I don't even know if I want to get those surgeries done anymore. Like, I'm pretty much okay now. You know, I didn't understand and realize how invasive these surgeries are. And yes, they are very invasive surgeries. Again, she didn't think about that. All she knew is that she wanted to get the excess skin and all that removed. But it's a lot of work. It is a lot of work. And, you know, even going back to when she was at the doctor's office and, you know, he told her it would be like some numbing and tingling or whatever, like around like her stomach area. And she asked him, like, well, how long is this going to last? And he said, it could last forever. And she was just like, what? And then, you know, becomes upset because she is tired of June with the back and forth. And yes, I'm going to get it. No, I'm not going to get it. You know, Gina's explaining to her, look, you wanted this. I'm here to support you. And now you got me all in and you have me doing all this extra stuff. And now you are second guessing yourself. Like, if you continue to do this, like, I'm just gonna like leave. And June is like, you know what? You don't have to leave. I could just fire you. So Gina was like, well, if you're gonna fire me right now. So June was like, fine, bitch, you're fired. And I was just like, oh, no, like, I like Gina. Like, well, Miss June returns back to Georgia and it is 8 weeks until Sugar Bear's wedding. So she only has 2 months. So she walks into the door and the girls are talking about this red dress, asking each other, do you think like mama can still fit the, you know, do you think she can fit the dress now? And, you know, one of them are like, you know, I think it's probably too big for her now or whatever. And so June automatically catches an attitude with the girls and, you know, tells the girls that she doesn't care about the red dress anymore. She doesn't care about the wedding. She doesn't care about the photo shoot. You know, she's just in a real bitchy mode. And, you know, they are just stunned, like, okay, so all right. So June is pretty much like, okay, I'm just gonna go upstairs, go to bed, whatever. So she goes upstairs and June then becomes depressed, very depressed. People are calling her. Jennifer's calling, of course. She sends her a voicemail. Kenya calls, sends her a voicemail. Gina calls, and like, even though she fired Gina, Gina is still there being her ride or die. She sends her a voicemail as well. It is days later. She's still going through the same thing. You know, the girls are going up there checking on her. She's not answering the door. And on day three, she finally gets up enough courage to call Jennifer back and let Jennifer know, like, fuck your wedding. Excuse my French. Forget your wedding. Forget, like, you, Sugar Bear, like, forget everybody. Like, I just don't want to deal with any of you. And, you know, Jennifer, of course, then catches the attitude. And she's like, you know, Mike is going to hear about this. So she goes out and tells Mike. And Mike was like, I told you how June was. So, I mean, what do you want me to do? It's nothing that I'm going to be able to do. So later on, Pumpkin knocks on June's door. June is not answering. You know, they're fixing lunch and she's not even coming down to eat. So they know it's a serious problem. And they have to come up with a way to get her out the room. Especially since the doctor already informed them that if she does not walk around, that she could form these blood clots and potentially pass away. They don't want that to happen, of course, to their mother. So Gina calls again. Again, June sends her the voicemail. And then Gina ends up calling Pumpkin. So Pumpkin is like talking to Gina like, I thought mama fired you. And she was like, your mom fires me all the time. Look, I didn't cancel the surgery. The surgery is in 2 weeks. What's going on? So Pumpkin tells her, like, you know, since mama came back from LA, she hasn't been, you know, in her right mind. She hasn't been feeling herself. She's been locked up in her room. She won't get out of her room. And we don't know what to do. So Gina's like, you know, we have to come up with something and figure out what to do because we really need this to happen. She's at pretty much at the finish line. You know, we believe in her and we have to get it done. So, you know, it's real hard to see that June has gone through all this for her just to be depressed. And it, all those surgeries could be depressing because, again, you're looking at it as like, why am I doing this again? Like, why am I cutting up my body and why am I going through all this pain for what? And when you're going through it, you don't see the outcome or the end results. But I think June is going to look a freaking amazing and I can't wait to see what she does. They have 2 weeks to kind of get June out of her rut and get her back to LA to get her gobble gobble and her bat wings done. So Pumpkin goes and takes the trash out and notices that June has thrown away the red dress. At this point, June is giving up on everything. And, you know, she comes in and lets Solana know that June has gotten rid of the dress. And it was in the trash can. So they have to come up with a plan. Now, what the plan will be, we don't know. But we shall find out next week on Mama June's From Not to Hot. Thank you all for watching the video. Again, like, comment, share, subscribe. And let's talk about and discuss this episode in the comment section below. I'd love to hear what you all have to say. I just want to thank you all again for watching me every week. I'm sorry that this one was a little late. I was again in Atlanta, which I had informed you all on the last episode. But I'm back and I will be back on time. So again, thank you and I hope you all have a great day. Bye.